Record. Oh, whoops, I hit record to the computer. There we go. Hi guys, welcome. Welcome to Essential Oils for Every Age. Can you see my screen? Yes, everybody's muted. Hold on. As soon as I hit record on Zoom, it doesn't give me the why. Hold on 1 second, there it is. I always have a minute because I use my on my laptop I have like the touch screen at the top, so I use all the cheats on the, what do you call it, the images along the top of my keyboard but then Zoom takes over and I can't use the PowerPoint that I normally would, so my apologies and being a little bit clunky always at the beginning of a Zoom. I'm excited about tonight. Actually, it's been a hectic Thursday. I've had a lot of people saying that they've had some big things going on in their world this week, so I'm not sure exactly what that is. I think some extra stress about world events and what have you, or just, you know, for me it's my two-year-old stretching me and big work shifts. So big breath, everybody take a breath, jump in the chat, tell me what you're diffusing. Tell me what oil you've used today that you have been in love with. Feel free to unmute yourself. I like doing this at the beginning of a session because what are you using? What are you loving? What did you open today that you haven't used before? What's in your diffuser?
Who was that? Lauren? I was just going to say, I actually just had a bath, so I'm feeling like super relaxed. I'm feeling like really relaxed, and so I have to wake myself up, so I'm using the Yoga Collection Ascend. That just makes me feel beautiful.
Ah, yes, Ascend. Yeah. You'll be lifting us all higher this evening.
Yeah, beautiful.
So good. I've got Elevation in my diffuser today because I've needed the extra joy. Who else wants to type it in the chat if you want to? I'm going to get going into this session. Feel free to ask all the questions. This is one of those sessions where I feel like I can't really do it.
Is that Lauren? Is that someone who was making a comment first?
Go for it. You're good.
Just quickly wanted to say it wasn't for myself, but my auntie ended up in hospital last Friday. She had a heart attack. It was really shocker. But she in hospital could not sleep. So I took some lavender peace for her and she had two blissful nights of sleeping.
Amazing.
She really, really just was, I can't describe it. So that was my proud moment of last week. And it meant the world because she was literally, her bed was opposite the nurse's, so you probably know the nurse's desk.
We talk way too much.
but she, you know, obviously she was looked after, but she could not sleep. So she literally, I showed her one drop in the palm of hand, like Sophia showed me, and it did wonders. So she said one drop.
Seriously. Amazing. And that was Serenity, the lavender peace blend.
Yes.
Yeah. So don't underestimate, and I say this all the time and it seems a little bit cliche, but try it. The right essential oil, so whether it be a more complex expert blend or whether it be just a neat single oil, don't underestimate the right essential oil in your worst moments for your thing. If you grab the right thing, so sometimes it's a bit of trial and error, but man, like this morning when I was really struggling, I had a couple of drops of frankincense under my tongue, and then I inhaled some Elevation, and then because it's that time in my cycle that just started, so the Clary Calm for me and Steady. So I'm going to be talking about those oils this evening as well. This session, so keep going on the chat, guys. Chat away with what you're diffusing, what you're loving this week, what's new and good for you. I feel like this session really doesn't do justice to all the options that we have, and I don't have the time to be able to cover all the things. So this is one of those, just the tip of the iceberg. So for those of you who are on live with us, feel free to ask all the questions as we go through, this show. And now I'm getting this show, slideshow, that's what I'm saying. Click. So pregnancy, I get asked all the time, what can I use during pregnancy? So the first thing is the Long Life Vitality, using that for the womb, right? So we're talking about baby health as well as the all important mummy health, because we know that when we're happy and healthy as a mother, it makes a huge, huge difference to everything from the gut health and the baby all the way, well, as we know, very closely linked to their emotional state and how calm they are, as well as their immune system. So gut health is really, really important. Hence why Terrazyme is the one on the slide straight up. So taking digestive enzymes, if you choose to, then they recommend taking them with every meal. This will pass through the breast milk when you're breastfeeding. So not the blood-brain barrier when you're in the womb, but for breastfeeding particularly, this is an awesome one to be able to get that extra level of enzymes, and also taking a probiotic for baby as well. Capybara is one we know for reducing stress and anxiety. We talk about a lot with nerve damage, but it also can support your milk. Fennel is the other one to go to. So fennel, you can do in a roller. I can't tell you how many new mums have come to me for oils when they've been struggling with getting their breast milk to come in, and you simply make up a roller. From the top of my head, I think it's geranium and fennel and possibly lavender and capybara that we put in that blend and put over, like, just on your breasts, away from your nipples. And I used a lot when I was breastfeeding essential oils for dry and cracked nipples. People are like, well, baby shouldn't be ingesting essential oils, but it does absorb into your skin pretty quickly. And the other things that we give babies at that age, I'll take the plants every day of the week. Even the, what's the purple one, the lanosin. There's a number of other products out there, and I tried it out this last time I had a baby. So I've done pregnancy with and without all of these doTERRA products. So I feel very blessed to be able to offer options. And if you can see on the dark side of my face, there's a little bird hanging out there. So if you're wondering what the heck this is, if you weren't on our chat before, then there's a, what is it? I don't even know. A pretty bird.
Peach face.
Peach face. Thank you. okay, so there we go. So apply topically basil and fennel, and I also just mentioned lavender and capybara for that as well. So one of the cautions that we talk about now, I've had people say you can't use Digestin when you are pregnant. You absolutely can. It's highly recommended, and also when you are breastfeeding as well. Peppermint is, For some people, it will affect your milk supply. So you please use caution when you are breastfeeding. It's been amazing for me when I've wanted to wean. So I've done that with two of my kids when I've wanted to get them off breastfeeding. It actually just reduces your milk supply and changes the taste of your milk a little bit. So the babies will more naturally wean off when you are ready to do so, which for me both times was about 14 months with the last two. Not that that matters. Breastfeeding is a massive, massive part of having a newborn baby. So I'm super grateful to be supported to continue, so that increase your supply, to decrease your supply. And like we talk about often with using essential oils and plants, you are naturally enhancing what your body wants to do. So it's improving the outcomes. You're not going to do like big damage that way. So infants. So with little kids, so this session, if you're just joining us now, it's kind of womb to tomb. So we talk about womb to tomb drugging. This is some of the swaps that we can be doing. And I'm just going through these slides and talking about bits and pieces. Feel free to ask any questions at any of the ages that you can see on the screen, because obviously there is way more than what is in this presentation. With infants, I could talk about bum sprays and what else do we use, like how to do your laundry wash and nappy bin spray, for rashes, for all sorts of skin things. So I'm just kind of tippy-toeing along the top of everything, because I could do an hour session on each of these ages. So feel free to interject if there's something personally that you want to ask.
Teething. Teething's another common one that people ask
about. Teething, thank you. Yep. Okay, I'll talk about teething. So On Guard Touch. So using this, and I grabbed the oils that are sitting at my front door. This is one tip. This is not our ad habit, which I haven't been clever and done an extra slide for, sorry. But putting your oils where you will use them. So these sit at my front door, and I'm going to show you what I have here as we're going through this evening. But one of them, which is on the screen right now, is this On Guard Touch. So On Guard Touch roller. It also, I have it in this version, which is the On Guard bottle, which I've diluted a little bit, but not as much as the touch roller. And it's just got a roller ball on the top of it like that. So that's a great way of repurposing your 15 ml bottles. You can get, just dropped a drop on my computer. You can get these roller tops for about $1 each, and they're a great way of, you know, it's a cheap, great way of being able to use your rollers. I do that when I'm putting extra things in as a blend, and when I'm diluting things, also to get the end of the bottles out. And I like having handy rollers around the place because rollers are awesome for kids. So applying to the soles of their feet and up their spine as a daily practice for kids makes a huge difference into the immune system. And I had a girl who was going to join me in teaching this evening. She's unfortunately been called away to work, but she has an incredible story about documenting, because she's one of those people who's like on it like that, how many sick days she had from work once she had kids, to the point where she was just about going to lose her job because she had stretched out all of her leave. And that was when we introduced doTERRA, and I was like, look, the On Guard, it's awesome. Totally didn't believe me. Whatever, I'll give it a go. She said she documented from the 6 months prior and the 6 months after of when she was using essential oils, and obviously dramatically reduced the days off work that she was having because her kids just stopped getting all the bits and pieces from kindy and daycare. And like anything, if you want to be successful at it, it requires consistency. So please don't use On Guard once or twice and say, oh, look, I've been really sick. You need to be applying this as a regular thing for you. So if you have a handy roller like this one, or you can get the touch rollers directly from doTERRA, either way, I like having them in a roller somewhere where I'm going to be able to use them, apply soles of feet and up your spine. Lavender. Now, lavender is known as our Swiss Army knife of all the essential oils. This is great for burns, bites, cuts, stings. It's amazing with babies. So, and I'm just check if the next slide has my teething blend in it. I'm not sure if it's, might go to the, I'm talking about unscented lotion, Frankie, and a diffuser here. So the teething blend that we, I highly recommend is actually Siberian fir, capybara, and lavender. So lavender is great for teething as well. Frankincense in a touch roller like that. Don't have my Frankie in a touch roller next to me. I've got it in the 15 mil because I was going to tell you guys about taking that under your tongue like I did this morning. So using it as a touch roller for kids, everything being diluted for babies is really important. So all of you would have had access to, if you haven't received physically your welcome pack yet, then organize to do that from myself or Sophia. The post is really slow at the moment, or if you're local and we haven't had a chance to have a coffee yet, then that's probably still on its way. But in our community groups, there is dilution ratios. I'm going to talk a little bit more about that as well. But as a good remembrance hack, it's kind of 1-10 ratio when you're talking about little babies, up to 1-1 ratio that you can use for adults. So dilution is really important. I'm put the unscented lotion here, lavender, for restful sleep, obviously, but you can throw anything that you want in there. So if you enjoy like oiling up your baby and giving them a good back massage, soles of feet, up their spine, then that's awesome. This is another option for you if you're not using a fractionated coconut oil or sweet almond oil. This lotion from doTERRA is beautiful. It actually absorbs really well and is just a bit different from, you know, using a carrier oil. And diffusing. So diffusing is really, really important with babies. Did you want me to go? You're on the chat, aren't you, Sophia? Could you just type in that those oils for teething? Because I know that was a question that we had. Siberian fir, capybara, Roman chamomile, and lavender is my like best teething blend. But if you don't have all four of those, then use what you've got. Frankincense and lavender are the two that I recommend for teething. If you have the top 10 essential oils, use those two for teething. And then add in Roman chamomile if you've got a baby, is amazing for eczema, for spots, for all the things. Roman chamomile is a good one.
What are your thoughts on clove Jess, because there's mixed reviews, mixed reports about that one, isn't there, for babies?
Cloves are really awesome. It's known as being an antiseptic, like it's a good numbing agent for oral health. Myrrh is actually the best thing for oral health. You could use clove, a little bit of clove in a teething blend for babies just to try and have a bit of that anesthetic kind of effect of it. I personally haven't because I've found the others really effective and just soothing. And, you know, especially the Capybara and Siberian fur work on that muscular discomfort, because a lot of the pain that they have from the teeth coming through is that their jaw is tensing. So it works on relaxing those muscles. You want to see some of the stats on Bonjela and, you know, even I've had to say.
Yeah, shocking that stuff. I thought that stuff has been banned or being called for being banned.
They had to change the packaging though, because people were putting it onto a spoon and putting a spoonful of it, because like the old school give medicine on a spoon into babies' mouths, and it comes like a big glob, and babies were choking. There was a number of instances of their airways being blocked from a glob of Bonjela. So they try and make it very clear on the packaging to put it on your finger and rub into gums, but you can do that. So I've definitely done that with essential oils, Copaiba, neat on the gums, Copaiba. If you're comfortable with using oils internally on a baby, I've definitely done that with Leo when he's been like hardcore teething, and I know that that's what it is. Sometimes with kids, you don't know what's going on. So you want to be knowing that that's your direct issue. Otherwise, when you use a teething blend, you go up your jawline and it's outside, you know, up here and around here, obviously on the outside on your face there. So diffusing essential oils is the safest way around little people. It's also highly effective, because as you've been in these sessions for a few weeks now, you would know that when we inhale something, it's going through our oil factory system and straight into our limbic system. So that beautiful gray matter that sits at the front of our brain that holds all of our memory and emotions. And, you know, we're chemically changing what is going on in our brain. So do not underestimate being able to diffuse the right things in your environment. I genuinely feel so much better when I have the diffuser on than if it's off. You forget about it. And we had that as our ad habit in the very first week. Get your diffuser on. Throw some oils in it. Get in the habit of turning it on. I was talking to somebody yesterday. Switch the kettle on. Switch the diffuser on at the same time in the morning. Add that in as a habit. Let me know in the chat if you've been doing that and you're loving that. So here is just a slide of a few oils, because sometimes I forget to mention them. Balance. So balance is great. You can actually use that for nappy rash too and skin discomforts, because of the beautiful woody grounding stuff in there. Sleep, obviously, from Roman chamomile, and teething. Frankincense, we talked about that from a calming perspective. I forgot to mention for baby acne, yeah? And cradle cap. So lavender and frankincense for cradle cap is also really great. Reducing temperatures is peppermint. So again, for little ones, we want to, you know, dilute that further down. Cardamom. So wild orange, cardamom, and Digestin for that gas, constipation, tummy upsets. They tend to be the two major things that we get with babies, is, you know, digestive issues, because they're having to learn, you know, how to absorb all these new foods and breast milk and how their digestive system is working. So if you can focus on a little person's digestive system, if you don't know what's going on, I always rub, you know, wild orange and Digestin into the belly and then use a teething blend around their face, and you're covering all bases beautifully and safely. If you've got the Tamer blend, that one comes from the US. But the kids oils collection, which I busted this one out today because Mr. Two was being all kinds of hectic. This is Steady. This is the grounding blend from the kids collection. So you can see Karma on the screen there. That's our restful blend. And the kids oils come with little cards too. I think they still come with the cards in Australia. Anyway, they're really applicable to them. They're nice and clear on the bottle. It's got either a heart or a brain or a body, so that you're looking at your mind and your body and your heart, your intuition, your emotion, your spirit. So it's really clear for kids exactly what that targeted support is. And of course, we talk about this one a lot, is balance and wild orange. So soles of your feet, for kids that are like tantruming and going crazy, it's a good one to put in your hands and be able to use that aromatically as well. So that's part of the calm the farm bends. So when kitties get a little bit older, then we start looking at using, so we've got the PB Assist and the kids. So this is the kids kit. So you've got the A to Z, which is the vitamins, they're chewable vitamins. I first tasted them and was like, they are chalk. I don't think my kids will eat them. And they love them. And I also told them, did you get a smiley face or a sad face in your vitamin today? Because they have little faces on them. They still haven't figured out that they're all happy faces. So that's been a win for me emotionally as well. I got a happy face. Well, must be a happy day for you then. Omegas are really important. We talk about this a lot from a brain development point of view, lubricating what is going on in your neurogenic pathway. So having this for our awesome, with a capital A, emphasis on the A, for our awesome kids, if you're picking up what I'm putting down there, this is exactly the first thing that I'll be looking at, those IQ megas. So that is a liquid and I take it off a spoon and it tastes like wild orange. It doesn't taste like fish, of course, because no little kids would just drink fish oil off a spoon if it tasted foul. And then the box on the left that you can see is the probiotic. So that is a watermelon strawberry flavor, and they are like sherbet sticks. My kids actually just take them straight out of the packet, but I like to put them like on porridge or in a little bit of milk, and they can drink them back like that as well. The On Guard beadlets are actually a great option for internal use for little kids. So my now 5-year-old has been taking these since he was 2. He quite enjoyed the taste of them. It is 1/4 of a drop of essential oil in those beadlets. So they're great to have as adults because you can just have the packet and pop them, and they're tiny, tiny little beadlets. I don't have any on my desk because I'm trying to create an office. Here's the kids collection. We talked about that. My kids have these packs. They take them to school with them. We also have some specific blends for grounding. We had our own pre-made blends before this collection came out, and now they're taking these ones, which is awesome. But you can definitely make your own. What works in the balance and wild orange is the first thing I recommend for every kid, who, particularly the preppies. I'll do a back to school thing, and we'll talk a lot about the back to school stuff next year as well. But pre-diluted, and they're easy and convenient, and like I mentioned before, they're specifically addressing those mind, body and emotion stuff. And for those of you on the call who don't have babies or little kids and don't intend to, thanks for sticking through this info with us, because you may or may not have colleagues or family members that this information will benefit. So wild orange and vetiver. So vetiver is a grass. It's known as our liquid Xanax. And from the focusing perspective, it's great. We talk about that as a homework helper. So to be able to sit still, because often kids of this age are bouncing, well, mine anyway, I don't know about anybody else on the call, but mine are like bouncing off the walls, need to be calmed down to be able to focus. Stronger blend. So that's the other one that I have at my front door, which has gone into somebody's bag because it's not in front of me. So like On Guard, this is the kids collection version of the On Guard. So it's a protective blend as well, but that has rose, litsi, and cedarwood as its main ingredients. Very different from the clove, wild orange, and rosemary base that the On Guard has. So completely different smell. Love my stronger. I use that all the time, particularly during winter or any seasonal change. So whenever we're changing seasons, I up the use of stronger for that first week of every season. Tamer, we mentioned that before about gas and tummies. So here's a day routine for homeschooling. We've had a lot of homeschooling this year across the world. So here's an example of, you know, using balance in the soles of your feet at the beginning of the day, diffusing the On Guard during the day. Now, just a caution on that. This is, as it says at the top of the slide, is homeschool. I actually recommend that you don't diffuse On Guard in public spaces. The reason being is that it has a little bit of rosemary in it, and there is a tiny bit of research around rosemary could potentially cause seizures in some people. So for GP clinics, daycare centers, and schools, I way prefer to use something like wild orange on its own, so that there's no possible reason for, you know, any issues coming up with that. And then in the afternoons, of course, frankincense and a palm and inhaling some of that. And then in the evening, like Sophia just did, having a bath with some Adaptif and Epsom salts. Yay for the win with the Adaptif. Oh my gosh, seriously, needing all of that. I took Adaptif capsules today. Well, not early enough in the day, this afternoon, and I've been feeling much, much better. In the morning for kids to be able to get them up and out of bed and focusing, wild orange and peppermint together, peppermint obviously for energy, and then the Thinker blend, applying that to the temples and the back of the neck for focusing during school, and then in the afternoon, same for everybody, right? Same. If you're working from home, these are some great options for you to be focusing in the afternoon. Having some peppermint, inhale some citrus, drink a bit of citrus, and of course, easy air and lavender, diffusing that in the evening. So now we're going into more of those teenage years. So this is when we can start adding in a half dose of the Long Life Vitality, which is an amazing way to be supporting, because often around the teenage years, they tend to want to eat more pizza and less pasta, or girls are just starving themselves and only eating salad and cream cheese on toast or whatever. They drop a lot of nutrients around this time, and obviously when little bodies are growing, sorry, a little bit distracted by this, my lovely friend who's playing with my hair, there it is. So Long Life Vitality is obviously the high dose nutrients for all of your omegas as well as your food nutrient complex. We talk about the Long Life Vitality a lot, so I'm not going to go into that at all in this session this evening. The HD Clear Skin range. So I use this. I have the foaming cleanser, which I use intermittently with the Variage, or when my skin's a lot drier in the winter months, I use the more moisturizing essential collection. Next week, we've got Tash, who's going to do a whole session on skincare and dive deep with that. So I'm not going to go too far into that. I've been working a lot with adolescents. This last 6 months, actually, I've had half a dozen mums or so that have come to me with kids between the ages of 12 and 16 that are self-harming, eating disorders, medical admissions for, you know, bits and pieces. So for kids who don't want to use essential oils, this is, again, diffusing. So having a diffuser in the hallway when they walk out of their room, if they don't want them in their bedroom, having that, and it's a powerful, powerful way of shifting the atmosphere in your home. It also helps get us. So like with little two-year-olds having tantrums, we learned early on to try and have them enter my calm rather than me entering their crazy. And I've worked a lot with youth, and same applies there, that they enter our calm rather than we get nitpicky and go into all of the emotional stuff and enter their world. So being the adult is really important. So support yourself as the adult. Claricalm hormone support is in this slide because when you first start menstruating, obviously there's a lot that goes on with teenage girls at this point, but please do not use the Claricalm until they already have had their first period. Okay, so that's when we're recommended as a woman's monthly blend. After they've had their first cycle, you can start introducing that. So Intune, so like Thinker, this is the adult version of, I have that one at my front door as well, which you can see is being diluted. We used to have them in clear glass, now they're in amber glass, so they match the rest of the collection, which is nice. But you can reuse your rollers over and over, right? Reuse, reduce, recycle. We're all about that in doTERRA. If you haven't done our gift giving stuff and seen what we can do with our boxes, you know, all of the doTERRA boxes that turn up at your house, you can flip them inside out. They're the best for Christmas presents. Just a side note, not teenage girl support, but Christmas presents. I digress. Somebody keep me on track. Serenity, so lavender peace for calming. We talked about that at the beginning of the call. Thank you for sharing that story with Nana needing the serenity. I was going to mention that. Adaptif emotions, anxious feelings, huge through your adolescent years, as well as acne. So using tea tree, a lemon you can use, please don't use that before school or during the day, sunlight hours, but tea tree is great for drying out acne prone skin. And obviously the HD Clear range. The Variage Skin Collection is nice and gentle, so they're not necessarily breaking out, but you want to be able to support them and teach them how to actually clean their face properly, then that's a beautiful one to get them started on. Teenage boys, waking up with fresh breath and energy, getting them out of bed, lifting sleep. So these are awesome for boys. Tea tree, peppermint, wild orange, ice blue, or deep blue for, you know, all of the activeness. And look, my eldest is only 8 and I already use all of these products on him, bar the beadlets, because he doesn't like taking things internally. So as the foundation for adults, Sophia, feel free to unmute yourself because I can't see the chat. So unmute yourself if you want to interject any questioning throughout. Adults, guys, foundational support being on the long life vitality. So increasing energy, mental clarity, and decreasing inflammation, super important. So there is obviously a lot of things this whole series covers with using essential oils. Using lemon, that's a habit that we've already introduced, having citrus in your water every day. So add 2 to 3 drops. And look, 1 to 2 drops is plenty if you're using one of the stronger citruses, even Smart and Sassy, using that as a blend to be having in your water every day. And I want to interject the habit for this week is using frankincense. So I'm going to give you 2 options, so listen up. Using frankincense orally, so you can have a drop of this under your tongue, which is great because then you pause and you take a breath and you inhale it. The other way that I want to try using it, if you don't want to take it internally, is just actually getting a drop and just putting it on your forehead and having a little moment at any stage throughout the day. I know people who use it on the crown as well, so having it up here if you prefer that, but it's great for your skin. Frankincense actually is known for reducing dark spots and helps with wrinkles and all the things, so don't feel concerned about using that oil directly on your skin. So this is the add habit that I wanted to talk about for adults in this session, is using frankincense. So use that daily and notice the difference that it makes you feel. Sophia, did you have something you wanted to add in there?
I was just going to say about my routine with frankincense. I have it in the bathroom and I put 1 drop under my tongue, I put on my face, and then I inhale it off my the left over off my palm. So that's kind of my nightly thing that I do with Frankie. Love it.
Yeah, you do that every night. That's awesome. I'm into the capaiba at the nighttime. And I'm appreciating this habit because I used to use frankincense every single morning. And since I've introduced a few other things, I've left Frankie Boy on the shelf way too much. So I'm going to be bringing that back and doing this challenge with you guys as well. So for adults, these ones, right? Stress, self-confidence. You've heard me talk about bergamot. Oh man, this oil. So this was actually the first essential oil that I bought outside of the top 10. Because if you look up, and at that stage, we would go to Google. Now we know to go to the Discover Solutions site. So if you go to Discover Solutions Bergamot, it'll bring you up to the doTERRA site, or go doTERRA Discover Solutions. And that website is like quality information that has been peer reviewed, as opposed to Google, which will give you everything from Pinterest that anybody could have just made up. Using bergamot and a light feathery touch actually around the outside of your ears is nice, and I pair that with adaptive in the diffuser, any citrus plus adaptive in the diffuser. Bergamot is like what you would have for Earl Grey tea. This is not Earl Grey, this is my spicy tiger tea this evening, but you can drink the bergamot as well. And I saw a beautiful recipe for some spiced cookies with bergamot and wild orange in them today. So serenity is for calm, for sleep. This is a great one from womb to tomb, so across the ages there. Claricalm is another one that is balancing. So we talk a lot about this in our hormone support session, so I'm not going to go too deeply into that, but the general gist of it is that it's balancing your emotions. So that's why we don't need to know if your estrogen or testosterone or is higher or lower. You can be pulling your body back to hemostasis. So remember, all of what we're talking about tonight and always in these sessions is about supporting your body to have what it needs to be able to heal itself. Okay, so we don't talk about essential oils as curing, preventing, or treating any disease, but what we are doing is supporting our bodies to support themselves. So this is why it requires this level of education, so that you can know what you're doing and you can be empowered to have these moment by moment support options. So Immortel on the right there, someone's going to ask me what that is. That's Soyubel. That is our anti-aging blend, Botox in a bottle. That blend is amazing. If you gave me like three options for essential oils that I could not have in my life, that would be one of them for real. That has rose, frankincense, Hawaiian sandalwood, all of your top end amazing skin, but also what else do those ones do? Emotional support, right? It's so good. So get rid of your wrinkles and support your emotions at the same time. For the dudes, if you didn't see their men's aromatherapy session, that is actually on our Team Alchemy page that Paul Ovens has done at some stage in the last few weeks. Deep blue, ice blue, this rub, I use it more than my husband does because I have more chronic pain issues than he does. But the first time I used it, he's like, oh, that bedroom smells like the footy sheds. And I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry. And he's like, no, I love it. I think it's great. But as a natural support for muscular discomfort, then that is a winner pre or post workout, using it before you're moving your body as well. Copaiba, so for immunity, for your skin, Copaiba is a winner. Digest Zen, so if you've had too much wine and cheese or beer, bloating, any digestive upset, constipation, diarrhea, obviously we know that does that as well. Marjoram, so for snoring and for phlegm, this is a supportive one for sleep. We talk about it for muscular discomfort, but it's also great to be diffused and used for opening up your airways. I would also add an easy air as the number one thing to get started with for snoring. So if you have any blocked airway issues in your home, be it boys or girls or little ones, then easy air plus frankincense is the winner in the diffuser there. Deep blue, ice blue in a roller in a different form there, and the wild orange, obviously, because our dudes need to be supporting their emotions just as much as we are. So just a recap, aromatic. So what can we be using as a go-to? There's probably lots of things happening in the chat that I am not looking at the moment. Let me see if I can get that up on my screen. Citrus Bliss. Okay, so using aromatic stuff. Oh, you're talking about using bergamot in the skin. Same. Yep, you're catching up with me. I can see the chat now. Magic. So Citrus Bliss, creating an environment that is uplifting and toxic-free. Okay, we did a lot of toxic-free stuff. That was one of the swaps that's really simple. What's in those candles? Not great for even the natural, like unless it's just a true beeswax candle, which a lot of them are, and they're great quality, but you can't pick and choose the scents that you're using. And from a cost point of view, using a diffuser is literally going to be like, well, I think it's about $25 for one of those good candles, and it's got like a 50-hour burn on it, whereas you're talking about maybe $2.50 for the same amount of time with essential oils. So if you do the maths on that, amazing, right? Topical, so using essential oils, motivate. This is a winner, guys. And adaptive, to actually be reducing your stress, increasing energy. Do we not all want to increase energy and reduce anxiety and stress and tension? So using oils topically, don't forget about the power of that. And taking essential oils internally is just a daily habit, which I'm so integrated in that I wouldn't even know what to drink other than there's nothing else but water and tea and coffee, pretty much some soda water and then alcohol in my house. I don't really drink a lot of alcohol, but my husband enjoys beer or two. Grapefruit, lime, tangerine. Actually, I should have integrated it into this session, all the mocktail recipes. Sophia, have you seen some of that? Tash was sending us mocktail recipes today. There's a lime, mojito, and anyway, I'm digressing into alcohol now. You've been really vigilant with your lemon. Well done. switch it up, try some lime. Tangerine is our product of the month, and in the last 5 days, tangerine has gone into my sleep blend, into my brownies, into my yogurt, into my water. So tangerine is a really diverse essential oil as well.
And it's so good in fizzy water as well.
And some soda water or mineral water for sure. Yeah. So the glory years, fractionated coconut oil. So diluting. So when we're talking about this spectrum, we actually look at decreasing the amount of essential oils that we're using as we get older, as you would when you were born. So there's kind of a peak, which is about what we're at now for those of us between 30 and 50, and that age bracket there, this is where we use the most, this is the least, and then we start tapering off too. This is just how my metabolism is, the way that our body is. There's a lot that's similar at birth that there is at death, if you think about wearing nappies, needing to be fed. We always joke about that. But one of the most important things that I want you guys to pick up from this session is my heart towards making little switches throughout your life so that you are living longer. Because one of the main reasons that I personally started in this holistic wellness business is because I had this realization working in ICU that we are dying longer and we are living shorter. So I want to make sure that we're living the most that we possibly can be, and living as in enjoying every day from an emotional perspective, being able to move our bodies right until the day that we die is really, really important. And what we do now affects the rest of our lives. So what we've done in the past is in the past. We can be making changes and shifting towards what we want to create in our body. Sophia, you were talking about a couple of weeks ago about your complete cell renewal and how your body changes. So don't feel like you are in the too hard basket. I am 100% a believer in healing, and all things can be changed. So looking at the quality of the products that we have here is really important, and being able to think, just, you know how and when to use them. Bone nutrient complex. So this is talking about providing 100% of our recommended calcium, magnesium. This is, you know, obviously contains vitamin D. So vitamin D is crucial, and we don't get enough of it from the sun as well. Has helped us. Yeah. We are sicker than ever as a population. So I know we've talked a lot tonight about a few different things, and I'm getting distracted by the chat now. So I'm gonna just pop that to the side for me. So this is another way of looking at this visual for a ratio perspective. And pets. I didn't mention the dogs before. I have a bird on me while I'm talking, and I don't talk about anything we can use with pets. Because this is a wild bird, I straight away was like, you need to move out of the room that is highly diffused right now, because we're getting the baby to sleep. So I was like, I don't want you wild creature having this diffused air, because I didn't know what the essential oils were going to do, that level of potency for him to be calming down. Diffuser is safe though. I just don't know what to do with the wild animal. Using essential oils on dogs, we often talk about balance, lavender, wild orange, frankincense. We had, if you came to our collective drinks, I don't actually know who's on the call tonight, we talked about shrinking tumors in dogs, all of the Staffy breeds and the bulldogs and that class of dogs, whatever they are, excuse my ignorance, often get a lot of tumors. So using frankincense regularly for them is incredible. So using essential oils obviously has different chemistry depending on which essential oil. So these ratios are a general across the board, but for something like oregano, which is a hot oil, cinnamon is a hot oil, you want to be making sure that you are diluting that more than you would if you were just grabbing something out of the bottle that you're used to on your skin. So it's really important if you're using anything topically. Lavender and frankincense are the exceptions to that. You can use both of those neat, safely. Balance is the blend that you can use neat, topically. Everything else is needing to, what does that mean? Hot oil. It's hot. Like if you put that on your tongue, it's given you a good kick. So it'll burn you. So we use oregano for literally burning off warts, using them on our feet. But you can have a toothpick of that or a drop of that in your bolognese and get that beautiful Italian fresh herby aroma and taste. It's not, so you want to be diluting it. Does that answer your question? Hot oil. Yeah. So there's a few of them, but that's the first one that you need to be aware of. Oregano, cinnamon. A lot of people, because obviously there is cinnamon in On Guard as well. So On Guard clove is quite a spicy one too. So On Guard's one to use caution around. Instead of using that neat on your skin, you definitely want to dilute that one as well. Symphony of the Cells. So I don't teach this. If you're part of the Empower with Essential Oils, which everybody on this call this evening has access to, then Michelina Knight, you will know her. Michelina, she is brilliantly trained in teaching the Symphony of the Cells. This is that next level once you're comfortable with using basic essential oils, that this has different protocols for specific conditions. So I normally have my book in front of me. There is like digestive, hormone, autoimmune. You can literally look up whatever it is that you're dealing with, but the basic Symphony of the Cells one is frankincense tea tree. Melaleuca is tea tree, same. Massage blend, which we have as Aroma Touch, and peppermint. So you can see the uses for them there, right? Using them internally, aromatically, and topically, and applying them on the spine there or around the neck. So those are the, thanks. You've done a better explanation there.
The Symphony of the Cells, I went to a training that Michelina runs, and I think she runs them fairly regularly, and it was amazing. Like, and you can get a really great book, and it gives you protocols for different things. So highly recommend if you've kind of got something more persistent going on. So trying to stay compliant here, but you know, if you've got something that you're much more concerned about, that next level from that, those everyday issues, I'd definitely recommend going to that.
Oh, it is the best education outside of this education, of course, that you're going to get at that higher end. She's an incredible communicator. If you can get onto one of those Symphony of the Cells.
Yeah, super knowledgeable.
She was doing them monthly. I don't think she's got any for November. I can double check with her. I'm not sure if she's will reply to me before I get off this call now. But she does them regularly. She does them in person if you're on the Sunshine Coast or Brisbane as well. COVID's been really interesting with all of this, but I'll make sure that she's doing them regularly for us online for next year as well. So don't know about November, but there'll definitely be January, February again for those workshops. And or you can buy the book and learn how to do it yourself. So as always in these sessions, we talk about a sample wellness box. So this is talking about a few of the US products here. The Australian version of is the kids collection is actually only $140. So, and nearly 100 PV. So if you throw a lip balm in your cart, then that'll get you over the 100 PV if you're somebody who is wanting to earn commissions or, you know, any commissions at all. So getting your Power of Three bonus. These are that whole collection. So if you have bought the top 10 essential oils as your starter pack, then using these as touch rollers as your next order is a great idea. The Long Life Vitality, if you enrolled last month, then you're going to get that for free if you place that 100 PV order this month, just as a reminder. And anybody who gets started this month also has the same opportunity for that. Sorry, Sophia.
Can I just add about the kids collection? That case in the background, that's only available from the US. So you can get the rollers here in Australia. Is that the Australian price, Jess? The one? Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's how much it is in Australia. It's
okay. Yeah, so the ones in Australia, they don't come with those colourful lids and the case, just because they're considered a choking hazard here in Australia by the TGA. But if you really like, you really want that case, I would order it from the US.
They really are a choking hazard, those lids.
Yeah,
because you know my kids have tried that out. Chew on them all the time.
Oh yeah, that's true.
And they don't stay on the bottles very well, so I actually took them all off mine. And I just noticed too that price. I haven't edited the slide because we had a discount on the Lifelong Vitality a couple of months ago. So it's $114.60 PV, not 54 PV for that. And not that as well. And then we go into use, share and teach essential oils. So we talk about this every week, your opportunity to refer a friend, bring them along to these sessions. Sophia taught a brilliant class last Wednesday as well. I taught yesterday on emotional wellness. We talk about detoxing. We talk about, so those are awesome sessions, lunchbox sessions. So that's 12 o'clock in Queensland time, 1 o'clock in New South Wales and Victoria. And you can refer your friends and you will get paid extra for that. It's a great way of just, you know, like Sophia, you're talking about how every company, whether it be Uber or Domino's, or I was talking to somebody on the weekend who bought a property in a estate, and if she referred a friend, then her and the friend both got cash for doing that. So this is the same thing, right? It's not gross at all. We really appreciate your referrals. We don't spend any money on advertising. It's all word of mouth. So we really appreciate that first point. Or if you want to be starting to share, hosting a session, we can come and do a personalized session for you in your own homes, or in a cafe or in a park, whatever suits you. Or you can take the option that we have in actually supplementing, and then like Sophia has completely replaced her income as well. So there is the options that you have. This is a bit of a graph onto the specifics on what that looks like. So you can be paying for your product in that amount of time. Supplementing your income, obviously we put a lot more time in there and there's more specifics around that. And then replacing your income, we're talking about some seriously big money. And then I'm just was talking about all we do is we do intro, basic training, wellness consults, continuing education, which is what you guys are all on now. We have a team call and then we have strategy sessions and contacting and following up people. And that is what we do. So if you're looking at this as an option for stop screen sharing there, then that is all we do in this business. So there's my like little add-on at the end there, but I really want to get to any questions because I have been off the chat. So let me know.
Are we going to stop recording, Jess, or you want to keep it going?
No, sorry. Yes, thank you. We will stop recording and then we will open up the chat. So thanks, guys, for watching this back, and send through your questions to us individually.